Tonight on Sunday Night Heat, Steve Blackman versus the Schnoz.
Thanks for joining us again, folks, as we move on to the second half of the first round of the WWF WrestleMania 2000 tournament. We have the Lethal Weapon, Steve Blackman, a former tag team partner of the world's most dangerous case of constipation man, Ken Shamrock. As you can see, the look on Steve Blackman's face, it rarely changes at all. And he's a student of Ming Chi's Stone-Faced Warrior Stone-Faced online courses. And you can tell by the non-look on his face that he has mastered that look. Perhaps only rivaling the great Ming Chi. And he's gonna need to keep that stone face because of the gigantic thing growing off of this man's face. I don't know what you could call that thing. People say it's a nose, but that thing has a life of its own. And I don't care if he's going back to his DX roots. Seriously, the gigantic Schnoz cannot be avoided. It must be discussed. It must be studied. Jesus Christ, thank you for covering it. Oh, good God. Yeesh. Seriously, I wish I took Ming Chi's Stone Face Warrior class so that I could have a stone face right now. If you saw the look on my face and seeing that hideous growth, it would be like, you ever seen The Ring? It'd be like when that girl saw The Ring. It's that bad, folks. I don't even want to look at myself in the mirror. But if it's between looking at myself in the mirror or looking at this Schnoz for another 15 minutes, I'd rather look at whatever hideous expression is going on here as he knocks Triple H to the ground. Oh, the shit breaker. You can see Blackman's eyes are actually getting wider, but he is keeping a stern expression. Sorry, going on and on about Triple H's nose. I forgot to talk about, the double underhook suplex. Forgot to mention that Stephanie actually kicked him out of the house and he is back together with China. They say they're on a break, but from what I've heard, it's gonna be a permanent thing. After Stephanie caught Triple H continuously trying to give her testosterone and whatever he possibly could to make her look even more like China. As Blackman starts wrenching Triple H's leg with a cobra twist. And an elbow to the Schnoz. I'm surprised that gigantic beak didn't cut open his arm. As Blackman shows that he too can kick himself in the face despite not having a gigantic snout. As he picks up Triple H. Triple H punches him down. And chops him to the outside as he misses a clothesline. Steps back in. Triple H grabbed him by the nose and chopped him down. Despite all the bad things going on in Triple H's life, he is definitely a decent wrestler at best. As Blackman barely grazes Triple H on a kick that definitely should have been a gigantic whiff, but due to Triple H's gigantic pecker, he managed to graze it. Nice elbow drops Blackman has been showing off through this entire match. And he knocks him down again, and another elbow. Working on Triple H's legs, an odd tactic to use by elbowing someone on the leg, as you would probably assume that it would actually hurt the person dropping the elbow more, but not in this case. And Blackman definitely getting the upper hand on Triple H for most of this match as he elbows him on the throat. Oh, and he connects with the boot. Once again, should have clearly missed it, but he's got a gigantic target in his face. Throws him off the rope. Oh, he's coming back. Oh, Triple H reverses a cross kick with a shot to the upper leg. Oh, nice knee strike, but Blackman reverses it. It's going up. I don't know what kind of high move Blackman has here. Oh, and he barely misses Triple H's face. Maybe Blackman needs glasses. Oh, and he gets the enziguri. Maybe he doesn't. And a headbutt to his leg. Very odd moves here from the Lethal Weapon. Oh, he hits Steve Blackman in his Mel Gibson. He misses the kick. Oh, reverse. Oh, and then he knocks Blackman down. Keeps going for those legs. Oh, Triple H with the neck breaker. China's not doing a damn thing out there, and nobody in the crowd is paying any attention to her, as Triple H is now using the odd tactic of elbowing someone in the shin. That bone-on-bone action's gotta hurt a lot. Oh, and a nice another elbow to Triple H's throat. Oh, that's a good shot from Blackman. That rat-faced X-Pac could certainly learn a thing or two. Oh, as he works the leg. Neither one of these two men wants to come out of this match blocking with all these attacks they're doing each other on the legs. Right there, and another elbow to the shin. And he tries to kick him in the leg. Oh, nice club to the back of the head by the H. One thing I forgot to mention, and I'm sure I'm going to wait. Oh, Triple H going up. Oh, and he actually gets a knee on Blackman's throat. Nice drop kick by Blackman. Oh, he's got him turned around, and he hits him with a hook kick. Triple H is capable of taking many shots to the face. He has a triangular cushion that is only rivaled by Toucan Sam. And speaking of Toucan Sam, as Steve Blackman hits Triple H on the leg again, I would like to congratulate Triple H on finally signing that lucrative deal with Fruit Loops to be their new mascot, as he hits Steve Blackman in the Danny Glover and elbows him on the leg again. It's been a long time coming, and it's been joked about very much behind the scenes, but he finally followed through. Not many children are happy about it, and I can guarantee that Fruit Loop sales are gonna drop drastically, because nobody wants to see that hideous Godzilla-like growth on the face of Triple H. He knocks him to the apron. Blackman really needs some help here. Constantly staring at that Beaky Buzzard's face is definitely having an effect on his eyesight, as he locks in a beautiful wrist lock on Triple H's heavily taped up wrist. But to be honest, I'm sure that Steve Blackman's just trying to not stare at that thing. Multiple knee strikes by Toucan H. Steve Blackman's gonna have to suck it up, unlike the rest of us, if he wants to have any chance of moving past this match to the second round. And Triple H needs Blackman in the leg. All of these leg shots are having a drastic effect, as these men are clearly limping around the ring. Coming up. Oh, and he hits him in the Joe Pesci! And really, who is authorizing these people to interfere in these matches? I know it's allowed, but outside of X-Pac and Stone Cold, we've had all these people who aren't even in the damn thing. Like Headbanger Mosh, you couldn't do anything better than that. Steve Blackman's got no hope. I mean, Triple H has China, but whatever. As he executes his master's big shitty power face slam head punch, he gets broken up. Back up. Oh, as China hits the headbanger in his headbanger. And back to work on Blackman's left leg. Oh, I don't know what the hell's going on over there with Bosch and China, but it looks intense. Too bad our crappy cameramen sometimes like to miss the interesting action. As he suplexes Triple H back into the ring. It does another big cheap power face slam head punch. Looks like Blackman sucked it up regarding his continuous face-to-face encounters with that factory-sized olfactory sensor. Oh, knocks it down. Oh, nice shot to Triple H's groin. Oh, no, he got a good look at it again. Back it off. Gets the first. Blackman's got the upper hand of that grapple and tosses him to the outside. Blackman is just not sure of himself. He doesn't know what to do. Oh, he's sucking it up to go to the outside. Oh, it gets... What a nice shot to Blackman's throat that was. And he reverses the Schnoz into the barricade. and Triple H knocks him down again. Trying to get some support from the crowd, but it's only China as she depends on him entirely. Oh, drops down. Oh, nice slam by Triple H as he celebrates by doing the classic disco move, the chainsaw. Going back to the legs as Triple H sweeps Blackman's leg, Cobra Kai style. Oh, what a club to his head! And a nice, what's a decent slam. Oh, and he hits him on his right leg. I don't think I've ever seen a match where both men are so intent on messing up the other's legs. Two. Oh, Blackman barely kicks out of that. Superb shot to his gargantuan thingamajigger. Oh, as he tries to give him a low blow again, but Blackman's not going to let that happen again. Triple H going up top. Not sure what he's going for here. Oh, and a knee right to Blackman's face. Perhaps Triple H is jealous that Blackman's not walking around with 45 pounds of meat on the center of his face. Oh no, here comes a pedigree! And Blackman's nose is busted open. Oh, that's probably gonna be it. Three. God, I'm gonna need some therapy after this one. You mean I gotta look at this again? Another disappointing loss in the tournament. Especially this one. We gotta look at this Woody Woodpecker piece of trash again. I mean, it's hard. It's hard. When his beak is that big and grotesque, gotta admit, he is pretty good in the ring. And he's got a pretty good understanding of the business. But damn it, just look at that. I mean, Props to our guys in the editing truck. They managed to find all the angles so that nobody at home is able to see the absolute hideousness of that creature on Triple H's. You can't even tell right there. It doesn't even look like it's coming out, but I can tell you, it is a sight for sore eyes. In the worst possible way. That's not usually used for, you say, you know, you are a sight for sore eyes if something's attacking. No, that is a sight for sore eyes in the worst way. I'm afraid shut down. But anyways, Triple H moves on to the second round of the tournament. And tonight on Sunday Night Heat, we will find out who he will face. I can't believe it, but the giant pea brain, the Big Show, has somehow made his way into this tournament, and he will be facing off against the gigantic Blue Guts, the Blue Meanie.